Hello and welcome everyone here to the Atlanta Motor Speedway for round number 18 of the Stanley Truck Series. The final race of the regular season. And should be an interesting race here at Atlanta. As Jacob Hollis captures the pole for his second straight race. Luke Martin in the 51-2 is outside. Behind them, Mitchell Collins and the one of Blaine Saylor and others. Let's get you down to pit road for the commands. And the commands have been given. Engines are fired up down there on pit road, and Jacob Hollis is going to lead them off of pit road. So we're going to talk about the playoff standings heading here into Atlanta. Nathan Orman leads the playoffs points with two wins. Corey Baker, Cody Goforth, and Blaine Saylor is second, third, and fourth, also with two wins. And then there's Daniel Bouchard, Mitchell Collins, Carter Joey, and Muhammad Zain Abdullah, all with one win each. And then after that, a cutoff, Michael Collins, he does has a win, have a win. Another win would get him into the playoffs and would kick Muhammad Zain Abdullah out of the playoffs, because Zain Abdullah does hold a final playoff position. Michael Brown, Case Russell are also in that same boat. If they can win here today, they will kick Muhammad Zain Abdullah out of the playoffs. And those are the only guys. Luke Martin, if he can get a win, he will get into the playoffs as well. Him and Brandon Mayhew, along with Lonnie Jones and Jacob Hollis, they will move into the playoffs and will most likely kick Carter Joey and Muhammad Zain Abdullah out of the playoffs. So we're going to keep an eye on those guys here.
Yes, we are. Thanks today for taking care of our tires.
The race. But here we go. Jacob Hollis, Luke Martin on the front row. They're going to lead us to green, and we're green and racing Atlanta for the second and final time this season and the final time on this racing surface. Real good start for Bahalts and the 98 of Mitchell Collins, who's gonna be right up there on his back bumper out of corner two. And now Collins is gonna look to the inside. NORLA is somewhat testing the super super speedway package that we'll be running here at Atlanta next season. Testing the package here today on this surface, but this is the last time they'll be on the surface as Jacob Hollis leads that lap. Behind them, three wide. Blaine Saylor washes way up the track with Luke Martin. Martin going to give him a huge push out of corner number two. Outside line really prevails out of that corner right there. Nathan Orman, who won here at Atlanta earlier in the season, trying to complete the Atlanta sweep, has Brandon Mayhew, who also needs a win. If Mayhew can get a win, Orman sideways in the corner saves it, and what an amazing save by Nathan Orman right there. Close call. Looks like he just the air just got taken off of the truck or something as they go four wide behind them. Casey Russell in the middle, 88 of Corey Baker. Oh man, Russell wants no part of that. He's gonna back way out of that right there. You can't blame him. Still pretty early in the race, 33 laps, still 20 laps to go. Or really 30 laps to go coming this time by. Is there still side by side for the race lead? Kind of a six truck breakaway. With Cody Goforth, Savannah Lyon. How about Savannah Lyon? Currently running in the top 10 right now. Four wide again, the 22, the 44, 34. Oh, Fisher washes up the track. Hometown for Fisher as we ride on board.
You're wide inside. Still inside.
Ooh, big run.
Too wide inside.
By the 22 of Tyler Ferris. Fisher is, I don't think he's ever won here at Atlanta in his career. It's part of Joey, who needs a win to get into the playoffs. Or, actually, no, he's in the playoffs right now, but would still like to get another win to ensure he doesn't get kicked out.
This kind of person, and it won't turn at all. It's got a bad vibration on the braking, and a real bad push.
Uh-oh, and that's not something you want to hear. That was the radio of Jacob Hollis saying they're picking up a vibration, especially when he's going for that brake pedal right there. So doesn't seem that it's affecting them too much right now, as he's going to get another big run on the outside, as well as his teammate Blaine Saylor, who has two wins locked into the truck playoffs. But we'll keep a close eye on that three truck. Remember, they had a problem while leading the race out there at Charlotte Roval. Starting on pole here again today, and just talked about a vibration. That team just can't seem to get their things figured out. The other team on that, I guess you could say the other team on that team, but Lane Sailor, you know, they found out some stuff. They've been really quick as of late with two wins within the last, what, five races. Back here, these guys are sort of separated, but that three truck team, man, they need to get their stuff figured out. And it needs to be today too if they want to get into the playoffs. These guys scattering all over back there. See Jacob Halsey still leading, so it doesn't seem like that vibration that they're feeling is affecting that truck at all right now. So, oh man, Blaine Sailor had to get out of gas right there. Cody Goforth now into the top five. He's going to be that second truck, that pink and black truck on the outside. He's going to try and cut down in front of Savannah Lyon, who's having a tremendous run right now, P3. Goforth back to the outside. Seems as, close call right there. I thought the 22 is going to hook the 92, but seems that Goforth, and as well as some of these other guys, is trying to find that perfect line of run here. We know you want to be on the outside in one and two here. You just don't want to get into that wall, as someone does right there. That's going to be the aid of John Goforth. Brush the wall a little bit. He's going to be right in front of Nate Norman. Singleton back here racing with Michael Collins and the 27 of Muhammad Zain Abdullah, who he needs to be on the gas as well. He needs to make sure he's there at the end, because he's, like I said, he's that driver who can get kicked out if someone with only one way. Oh, we've got a truck slow.
Right, middle one and two. I think he's losing a motor or something here.
Slow truck in there, wrecking. In one and two. Big crash here. The 30s around. Oh, Casey Russell comes flying in there as well as the 16, but they don't seem to make contact with anyone. Giorgio Satomu also collected. Danny Bouchard in the 87 with an issue. His truck is stalled at the bottom of the track there. And Jacob Holtz, he's going to come around and lead.
Caution south.
I'm going to lead them to the yellow. Caution flag is out. First caution of the day. Let's go back and see what happened. You see Stephen Wallace Jr. right there in the 02 collected with heavy with damage. Oh, something must have broken on the 87. He slowed down big time. And then 97 comes running into the back of the 7. And then you see everyone just compiling in there. Into the wall, Michael Collins. He did not need that here. Today, another look at it. See this 87 Bouchard. Something broke. Was trying to go to the apron. And these guys checking up and just not in time. See the 20 as well. It's just one of those things where you only have a split second to react. And that's what happens right there. 34 of Henley also collected in the incident. 4 and 49 was able to get by. Michael Collins.
Slow running. Go more around the corner.
Heavy hood damage for Randolph, and then he went around.
We're in it. Drive,
God.
Okay. You okay?
So, Austin's gonna be out for the first time here at Atlanta, watching the Stanley Truck Series regular season finale. We'll be back. Welcome back to the Atlanta Motor Speedway, the final race of the regular season, and also the final race on this track surface. So, Atlanta will be getting remodeled after this, after the final cup race on this surface. Still got the cup guys, I believe, will be coming here as well.
Like six coming to the green maybe here.
Not this week though, they'll be going to Homestead. But here we go, getting set to go back green. Green flag is back out. Baltz leads them. And wow, that 87 absolutely took off. Baltz did not go down pit road. A couple guys did not go down pit road. And now the guys with fresher tires are just going to go right by him. You can see the big, big deal and the big difference between fresh tires and not so fresh tires here at Atlanta. Tyler Ferris out front, ahead of the 98. He's going to cut down. 87 Bouchard is hoping for a quick yellow so he can get back on the lead lap. I think Jacob Halts, yeah, they didn't pit, and that was maybe a mistake. But maybe they're thinking long term here, so we'll keep an eye on that. Three truck, actually, no, he's really slow. Jacob Halts with some problems again. He makes contact with the 18 of Reed, but Halts on the apron.
Probably has a tire going down.
Troubles for the three of Jacob Halts, and for the second race.
The tire just fucking came apart.
Race in a row. Halts with issue, no yellow. And that's probably going to put them a lap down if they can make it back to our pit road three wide for the race lead. Not what Jacob Halts needed at all. He needed a win here today to get into the playoffs, as well as the seven right there of Brandon Mayhew. They've been off of pace as of late. Everyone up here still kind of a dogfight for the race lead. How about the 75 of Savannah Line? There's Bahals. Looks like he's just barely going to make it a pit road. But, of course, a ton of time is going to be lost. And he's going to need a quick yellow as well. Very, very tough break for Jacob Bahals. And a tough break as well for Michael Collins, who got in that incident. He was at the first car below the cutoff. Or the first driver below the cutoff. And Michael Collins will not make it into the truck playoff this season, despite winning at Texas early on in the season. Luke Martin right here getting a big push from Casey Russell in the 24. Russell has made his way back up here, racing for a potential win here. He's one of those guys who needs the win. Carter Joey, he has one win, but he currently sits seventh in the standings. Eight trucks can make it into the playoffs, so I don't think Carter Joey has anything to worry about at the moment. Bouchard, man, I'm telling you, that 87, they're hanging on for dear life right now. And Tyler Ferris is probably not happy with that. Tyler Ferris wants to get that 87 out of the way so he can get the race lead. You know how good the outside line is here in one and two, especially on the exit. Halts back out on the racetrack, and turns out they had a tire going down. Of course, we heard it on the radio. The tire just tore to shreds, so they definitely should have pitted. Four wide right here. Lane Taylor, Mitchell Collins, Cody Goforth, Tyler Ferris on in the mix. Savannah Line in the 75, leading the way right now. Showing these boys around the track. And she's going to go up and lock the 87. I think the last female to win in the truck series was Jennifer Buford. Here's a 7. Not a good day for Brandon Mayhew. You know, they definitely have the skills to wheel a race truck, but they've just been kind of off of pace as of late. Coming up on 10 laps to go pretty soon. You know, these guys can't make it all the way on fuel. And of course, tire wear is a huge factor here at Atlanta Motor Speedway. This surface just eats up your tires. Just eats away at your truck. As Cody Goforth dive bombing it, trying to get to 75. The inside has not worked so far. Unless you were one of those trucks that had fresher tires than the trucks that didn't pit. Just ahead of them is going to be the 3 of Jacob Halts. Not what he needed. Currently scored in the 28th position. Now the question is, when will these guys go down the pit road? Daniel Bouchard with a huge dive bomb, but I'm assuming he's going down pit road here, and he will. It's been a while since he's been on pit road. Savannah Lyon ran really well at the Charlotte Roval. He's running really well here again. At Atlanta, Mitchell Collins in that 98, way up to the outside. He's going to get a big run here down the backstretch. Will he stay with a 75 or will he go with Goforth? Looks like he's going to stay with Savannah Lyon right there. We'll see if he goes to the inside. This time, nope, he's going to stay up there. I believe Cody Goforth and others going down pit road. This could be the money stop if we don't get a yellow. Don't want any penalties. You don't want to get into anyone else on pit road. Atlanta, much easier pit road to get down. Then we all know what track Fitzwater. I'm sure he can tell everyone in the comments here, but Savannah Lyon continuing to lead over Collins. I'm assuming they're gonna pit.
Hustle around and pit this time. I want there you to is. Come around and pit this time. Be careful getting on the pit road down there.
75, 98, 22, they're gonna pit this time.
45.
And it was a money stop that got Nathan Orman the win at Atlanta earlier on in the season. There's Orman that I think that was Orman that just went by. Lengthy pit stop, 47 of Mayhew. One is out. Side-by-side, Carter, Joey, Cody, go forth. Tim Randolph, they ended up taking the hood off that thing, but... Sorry about that. I kind of had a little bit of issues right there, but... Nathan Norman is going to lead the 42. Steven James down pit road for their, what should be their final stop here. And we'll see what happens when everyone cycles back around. Some of the fastest pit stops on the track, the 13 and the 24. Amazing pit stops for them. We'll see where they line up here. See, they're going to go by everyone else who's just now coming out of pit road. So it looks like this may turn out just like the Atlanta race early on in the season, where the final stop of the race is what ultimately decided the winner. And Savannah Line with an amazing pit stop as well on that 75 team. Now here comes the 24 of Casey Russell in second. Nathan Norman still scored as a race leader though, but I'm assuming these guys will take over the race lead. Big run right here by Casey Russell on the outside of the 75. These guys got to make moves right now. There's Nathan Norman just ahead. Will the 24 get ahead of him? Into the corner. He's right there. Side by side. This is for the race lead. Coming to six laps to go. Five next time by. Casey Russell to the point at Atlanta. Savannah Line. Right now, currently second. Nathan Norman battling for third. Three wide with Carter Joey. There's Luke Martin in the 51. He was one of those guys who needed a win here to make it into the playoffs. Doesn't look like it's going to happen though. Teammates Mitchell Collins, Corey Baker. Collins, he's already into the playoffs. He has nothing to worry about. Just needs to take it home with a decent finish. There's the one of Blaine Saylor. He too is locked into the playoffs with his two wins. Him and Corey Baker both, as well as Cody Goforth. And Nathan Norman with the multiple wins on the season. And of course, Blaine Saylor joins that group as well. But right here, this is the big race for the win. And they're coming up on the slow truck of the 30 of Tim Randolph. They have ripped the hood off of that thing after being collected in that incident earlier. As they're dead even just about at the start-finish line. Four laps to go at Atlanta. Savannah Line, of course, not eligible to make it into the playoffs, but still a win is a win. Only top 30 in the standings. Casey Russell, ever since he stepped in at 24, has been making up the points, and he's lead 28th in the standings, so he becomes eligible for the playoffs. 400. Ooh, slow truck in the way, man. Where are you going to go? The 24 to the bottom. Three laps to go with Atlanta. Hopefully this doesn't turn out like the Xfinity race where no one decided to make a move till the last second, but to the outside of 75, Savannah Line is going to get a big run around Nathan Norman. A truck of John Goforth is up here as well. Outside, I believe the outside is really where you want to stay. That middle to that outside groove. Savannah Line trying to get Tim Randolph out of the way. Coming to two laps to go here at Atlanta. Casey Russell trying to go to victory lane for the second time this season. Savannah Line looking for their first win in, what, two starts, maybe three? Tim Randolph is not slow for some reason. Thought they would be way off pace, but they're actually keeping up with these leaders. But he's kind of in the way of everyone else. Nathan Roman on the bottom, not where you really want to be unless you can make it work, make it stick. As he's actually going to be able to get around to eight. Here we go, coming to the white flag. One more time around Atlanta for Casey Russell and Savannah Line, who's right there. Where will she go? Russell, I'm assuming he's going to try and hold that middle line. He goes up a bit high, trying to get that run off the corner. Half a lap to go at Atlanta. Casey Russell trying to get himself into the playoffs. Nathan Norman trying to go for two in that row in Atlanta. He's third, but I don't know. I think he's too far back to make a move. Can the 75 make a move? She cannot. Casey Russell, second win this season, and he's going to be into the playoffs. That kicks Muhammad Zain Abdullah out of the playoffs and brings in the 24. Casey Russell, a winner here at Atlanta.
Very, very proud of you, bud. Very proud of everybody on this race team. You guys worked so hard this week. I really appreciate it. Great job there, big girl. 10-4.
What a race. What a job well done for Casey Russell. He just kept it in the middle. Made sure that if the 24 had anywhere to go, it was going to be to the inside. Or made sure if the 75 had anywhere to go, it was going to be the inside. Because the outside line really prevails here at Atlanta, especially out of two. And once you get that big run out of two, it's all up to you to just, you know, hold the lead and block as much as you can. And that's exactly what Casey Russell did. How about that job well done by Savannah Line, though? Second place finish. Nathan Orman, another solid top three for him. He's ready for the playoffs. Casey Russell's ready for the playoffs. Stephen James, fourth place. I believe that is a career best for Stephen James. And Carter Joey rounding out your top five. John Goforth, the top 10 for him. Fisher, seventh in his home track. Tyler Ferris, Cody Goforth, and Muhammad Zain Abdullah rounding out your top 10. Muhammad Zain Abdullah got 10th, but Casey Russell got the win, putting Casey Russell into the playoffs. And
very nice job, boys. You give me a spot next to that girl with the blue feathers on down there.
Through the grass, Casey Russell goes. I believe that's what he did when he got his first win. I think it was the trucks at Talladega last season. Slid through the grass. Does it here again. They'll have to fix that for the cup race in a couple races. But Casey Russell, man, can definitely wheel it here in the truck series. That is win number four for Casey Russell, tying him at the all-time wins list with Daniel Bouchard, Cody Goforth, and Mitchell Collins. Those guys also with four wins as he goes through the grass again. This may have been one of the most, well, this may have been his most important win so far of his career. This win gives him a shot at his first title here in NORLA. But Casey, he's not the first Russell to win it here at Atlanta. Casey Russell has done it twice in Atlanta. Slowly becoming Russell territory here. But congratulations to Casey Russell on the win. He is now a playoff contender here in the Stanley Truck Series. Keep an eye on the Discord so you can see the full playoff standings. It's time to go racing for a championship, everyone. As the next race these guys will be at is the Worldwide Technology. That is a dumb name, by the way. I'm just going to call it Gateway. Gateway is going to be the next race. Then we head to Homestead, where all three series will be. And then Circuit of the Americas will be the final race of the round of eight. Congratulations to Casey Russell on the win. And we'll see you at Gateway. Goodbye, everybody.